magnetic field is due to the current. Right? We have introduced Biot-Savart law, and we use that law to find out the magnetic field for different types of current. When I say different types of current, since the source of magnetic field is a vector quantity, it really matters how the current is flowing. Okay, that source is of what? I into dl vector. Dl vector is in the direction of current. So it even depends on the direction of current. Right? So we have found out the magnetic field due to a straight wire, due to a circular wire. Okay? And then using that we have solved various questions. Okay, so we have seen that some of the very tricky questions can also be made out of those. So if you have solved the homework, how many of you met the target, last week's target? Why it happens always with you? See, you have to do it. It doesn't matter. There is no excuse to be given. Okay? I will not hear out any reasons. You have to do it. Full stop. Okay? Even if you have headache, throat infection, you're sick, nobody gives a damn about it. Okay? And that's how it is. I have also done like that. I'm not asking you something which I myself have not done. That's how the preparation is. That's why it is difficult. Okay? So it takes that. You must, I mean, these targets are minimalistic. They are minimal. And you have vacations going on, for God's sakes. Same target, similar amount of target you have to meet when the schools will open up. If you are not able to do it now, forget about JEE. You must meet the target. In fact, now since vacations are going on, you should double it or make it 1.5 times. Okay, I will not come every time and pull you or yourself up, you know, that okay, fine, please do a little bit more and do that. You have to push yourself. So you will not be able to do the assignments when the schools will open. If you are studying now, forget about it. Understood? Enough time is there for your home. Enough time. You are just wasting the time if you are not able to do those homework. Just takes 20-25 hours of your effort out of 168 hours in a week, and you don't find that time, something is terribly wrong. Okay, so last class we have seen that you know, some of the very good questions can be made out of just application of Biot-Savart law. Okay. So we know that in JEE Advanced, a question can come which can test you only on application of Biot-Savart law. Only on that, nothing else. Okay. So try to do a lot of practice yourself, try to search for some questions which are a little bit different, because there are not many varieties. You may tend to solve 200 questions and you feel good about it, saying, you know, thinking that you have solved 200 questions, but when you look back, all of them are similar, it does not matter. Okay. So you should look for the different types of numericals whenever you search or whenever you look for practice. So when I say the target is 100 questions, okay, it should not happen that you have the formula of magnetic field at the center, and then sometime r is equal to 5 cm, then r equal to 10 cm. Okay, so I am telling you very crudely, it is your responsibility to find out different kinds of numericals in yourself. Okay, I cannot go up to that level. Getting it? So try solving as many questions as possible and make sure you score 100% in this chapter. This chapter is extremely easy compared to mechanics and all those other things. Okay? It can be mastered easily and it can guarantee you full marks. There are very few chapters in physics which can guarantee you marks. Okay, so try to make this perfect, this chapter's preparation. Then what we did was that we have introduced, what is that, Ampere's orbital law. Okay, and we have used Ampere's orbital law for different types of symmetry. Okay, usually if you have solved problem, you might have seen that many times you have to take circular loop, right? And Ampere's orbital law is very similar looking to Gauss law, Gauss theorem, right? In Gauss theorem, we should know the direction of electric field and use that to find the magnitude of electric field. Okay, similarly in Ampere's orbital law also. The difference is that in Ampere's orbital law, we are applying that integral over a loop. Loop should be completed. In Gauss law, your enclosure should be completed when you integrate. Fine. So there are a lot of questions on just these two laws, Gauss theorem and Ampere's orbital law. Different types of numericals. And usually, you know, if a question from electrostatics comes, you know, 70-80% chance is there that it will be from application of Gauss law. Okay, because it's a very, a tricky concept, as in it's like a trick to apply to find the electric field. Okay, so there are some very nice questions which have come in previous year JEE, and also more than that, if a question on Ampere's orbital law comes, it will be purely on magnetism. There is no mechanics mixed on it. If a question on Gauss theorem comes, it will be purely on electrostatics. Again, no mechanics is there. So if somebody wants to give you a pure electrostatics question, 90% chance, Gauss theorem. Or a capacitor. Okay? And similarly, in magnetism also. Okay, Ampere's orbital law may look very straightforward, and there are not many numericals on Ampere's orbital law in your book. But have you solved the assignment and taken the test? You might have seen that there can be some good questions. What are you doing, guys? He started dancing.
There was a question.
Oh yeah, that's final one.
Oh yeah, I didn't get it.
Oh yeah, that was.
I shared the solutions also, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, but that's not the application of Ampere's
orbital. Yeah, that was pure Savart.
That was pure Savart. Okay, so these are the two things which we have done last class, Ampere's orbital law and pure Savart. Okay, they are the backbone of this chapter, and you should have done a lot of practice, and I'm assuming that you have done it. Alright, so next we are going to take up basic of the magnetism, which is what creates magnetic field. What is the basic cause of magnetic field? Basic cause is magnetic dipole. Moving charge will create a magnetic dipole only. Okay. Alright, so next we are trying to quantify what is magnetic dipole. It is one thing to know, okay, magnetic dipole is north and south. So I give you two magnets, and if I ask you how much is for that and how much is for that, you will not be able to answer if you don't know how to quantify it. Okay, so this is what we are trying to do. We are trying to quantify the magnetic dipole. Okay, and as Bharat said, that it is because of the moving charge. Okay, so we are going to define in terms of moving charge itself that magnetic dipole. Okay, smallest magnetic dipole is what? Electron and hydrogen orbit. Okay, so in a way, it takes a loop to create a magnetic dipole. This is like the basic understanding. Observational understanding, that it takes a loop to create a magnetic dipole. Okay, of course you can say that the straight wire has some magnetic field. So where is the magnetic dipole? You can say that it's a loop of infinite radius. Okay, so ultimately the basic cause we are going to assume is the magnetic dipole, and magnetic dipole gets created from a loop. Okay, and there cannot be any flow of charge without a loop. That is also given. Even though if I take a straight infinite wire, current is there. Can current be there without a loop? There cannot be a current. There has to be a loop. Okay, so in a way, if you say that current is a basic cause, every current will require a loop. Okay, so that is what we are trying to quantify. We will be quantifying the magnetic dipole in terms of the magnitude of flow of charge, which is current, and some property of the loop. Getting it? Alright. Now, if magnetic dipole moment is the basic cause of magnetic field, if I tell you that here is one circle and here is some weird loop, suppose this is a circle, okay, and let's say I give you another loop, suppose this is another loop, alright, so both have current in it, and if I tell you that magnetic dipole moment of these two are same, then if distance x meter away, its magnetic field is y, then what is the magnetic field because of this at a distance y away?
At a distance x away.
At a distance x away, its magnetic field is y. So at a distance x away, what is the magnetic field?
Y.
Same. Why same? Because it does not matter what kind of loop it is. Ultimately, loop creates magnetic dipole moment, and that is the basic cause. If magnetic dipole of both the loops are same, that's it. Okay, because ultimately the basis of the basic is the magnetic dipole moment. Alright. Now, the basic assumption when we studied the electrostatic dipole moment was what? That the distance where you are finding the electric field is very far from the is very large compared to the distance between the charges. Yes or no? Okay. Similarly, here also we will assume that distance where you are trying to find the magnetic field is far is large compared to let's say if it is a circle compared to the radius or diameter. Okay, and if it is like a weird shape, you can say compared to the perimeter, the distance where you are finding the magnetic field is very large. Okay, so if it is very large, you can treat it like a point, the entire thing, whatever kind of the shape the loop is. Getting it? So, this is where we start. So, I was about to rub it with duster. Okay. So, now if that is the case, that it is immaterial what kind of shape and size the loop is, what should I do? I will take it a perfect circle, because I know the formula for perfect circle already from the BOSR. Okay, so I will try to find out what would be the magnitude of the magnetic dipole moment using already derived formula of the circular this thing, loop. Getting it? Okay, now God hasn't come and told us that this is magnetic dipole moment should be this. He just created magnetic dipole moment. It is up to us how we can quantify. It is like length. God has created dimensions. It is for us to assume what is 1 meter, what is 1 centimeter and things like that. It is we who have defined it. Okay? But it is there to, we have to measure it. Similarly, if magnetic dipole moment exists, you have to measure it. Then only you will be able to control it and do various things with it. Okay? So, but then it should be logical. It's like if this is the length and that is the length. Of course, this is larger than that. So whatever unit you take, this should be more than that. The common sense should prevail. Then you can take any units. Alright? So similarly, suppose I have to quantify the magnetic dipole moment of a loop. What should it be proportional to?
Magnetic field.
Magnetic field is the effect of magnetic dipole. What do you think the magnetic dipole moment of a loop should be proportional to
current flow.
There should be a current. Without current, no dipole moment. Yes or no? Okay. So magnetic dipole moment is represented by a letter small m or capital M, depending on which one you like. Okay. And I like small m. So small m is proportional to current of the loop. Understood? What do you think it should be proportional to other than current? What do you think? It should be, there should be something related to distance between the charges, that was there in electrostatics. But there are no monopoles, so nothing like it. So there has to be something related to dimension of the loop.
Radius
is
separation.
You can say radius, you can say perimeter, whatever it is. Okay? But to make our life simpler, okay, so that later on whatever formula you derive comes out to be straightforward, we take magnetic dipole moment proportional to the area of the loop. This will simplify a lot of formulas. Okay? What else magnetic dipole moment should be proportional to?
Number of turns of the loop.
Magnetic dipole moment should be proportional to how many turns loop has. Okay? So if I combine all these three, I will get magnetic dipole moment to be equal to a constant of proportionality, okay, which can be 1 also, because this is a formula which I am creating, so why will I make my life to be difficult? I will just say constant is 1. In fact, even this is not true. This may not be true. You can say magnetic dipole moment is proportional to I raised to power A raised to power B, and N raised to power C. Nobody can object that. But to make our life simpler, we have taken the power of 1. Okay, so we are trying to derive the simplest possible formula based on the whatever observation we have. So magnetic dipole moment should be equal to NIA. This is the formula for magnetic dipole moment. Understood? And it's a vector quantity. Why should we take magnetic dipole moment as vector quantity? We have taken electrostatic dipole moment as a vector quantity.
Depends on the orientation. The magnitude depends on the orientation.
See, we are trying to define, we are trying to find out the magnetic field using dipole moment. We are trying, later on we will be trying to find out the force or torque with respect to magnetic dipole moment. So they are all vector quantities. Okay, so if there is a sense of direction, if I associate with the magnetic dipole moment, I can get the answer for torque, force or magnetic field in terms of the assumed direction of magnetic dipole moment. I don't need to specify direction of the magnetic field or torque separately with another vector. Getting it? So why not take magnetic dipole moment itself as a vector quantity? Then I can define the directions in terms of direction of magnetic dipole moment only. Okay, the direction of magnetic dipole moment is in the direction of area. Okay, and the direction of area, how will you find out? Suppose this is the loop, current is flowing like this. How will you find direction of area? Right hand rule. Curl your hand like this. How will the direction of area? Understood? Okay. Now, for the enclosure, you can define inwards and outward normal, because it is enclosing something. So there is something called inward, something called outward. There is something called inside and outside. But for a loop, there is nothing inside or outside when it comes to perpendicular direction of the loop. It is open from both the sides. Okay? So you can't say outward normal, inward normal. It doesn't make any sense. Okay? So there is only one way to determine area is right hand rule. This entire chapter is just right hand rule. You align your fingers in the direction of current, thumb will show the magnetic field. Align your thumb in the direction of magnetic field, your fingers will show the direction of current. It will be never wrong. Okay. Alright, so this is the quantification of magnetic dipole moment. Alright, let us try to find out the magnetic field in terms of magnetic dipole moment. right? So if I try to find the magnetic field in terms of dipole moment using a special case, will that be valid for any case? Suppose I find out the magnetic field, okay, due to a circular current at a point, alright, with respect to the magnetic dipole moment of the circle, okay, then does it matter that, okay, let me simplify it a bit. I think I'm slightly confused. Okay, what I was trying to say here, suppose this is circular lobe, okay, this is a circular lobe, over here magnetic field is there, B, okay, this is current I flow, right, suppose I find magnetic field over there, over here, as a function of dipole moment of the loop. Then I replace loop with something else, a permanent magnet if I place there, whose dipole moment is also M only. Will magnetic field change there?
No.
It will be same. Okay, so what I am doing here, I am trying to find magnetic field using a special case of circular current and converting that formula in terms of dipole moment. Then I am saying this formula is true for anything if I know what is M. Getting it? Alright? So let us try to do that now. So let's say distance is z, the actual distance is z. Alright? So what is the magnetic field at a distance z? We have derived this, how much it is? Mu naught I r square divided by 2 times of r square plus z square power 3 by 2. This is what the formula is. Okay, and of course whenever we are dealing with dipole moment, our general assumption is the distance is very large compared to the linear dimension of the loop. Okay, same assumption we had for the electrostatic dipole moment also. Okay, now can you find out the magnetic field B in terms of the magnetic dipole moment? And with that assumption, try doing it. Assume number of turns is capital M. If number of turns is capital M, N, then the formula
mu naught N.
Mu naught N I R square. What should I do?
Pi
now to get the area. If I multiply and divide by pi, mu naught by 2 pi, now if I take z outside, it becomes z cube 1 plus this is what I will get or not? Now, N I into pi r square is what? N I A, which is magnetic dipole moment. Okay, so this is mu naught by, let me take it as 4 pi because it's like a generic constant, mu naught by 4 pi, 2 N divided by, this will tend to 0, r by z. So this is z cube. This is the magnetic field in terms of the dipole moment. Getting it? Now, even if I place a magnet over here, whose dipole moment is M now, the answer will be exactly same. Now it doesn't matter whether it is a loop or not, as long as M is same. Okay, so first time we have derived the magnetic field in terms of its basic cause, basic cause of electric field is charge, but basic cause of magnetic field is a dipole moment. Now, this magnetic field is axial. Along the axis. Okay. Do you remember what was the magnetic field of the electrostatic dipole moment along the axial direction? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by z q. You remember that? This was the axial electrostatic field due to a dipole. Okay, now do you remember what was the equatorial electric field?
Half of this.
This is axial and equatorial electric field, write down 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus p by z cube. Yes or no? Now tell me what is the equatorial magnetic field? What it should be?
Mu
naught by 4 pi minus n. In your book it is written plus n, which is not correct. Okay, so electric field and magnetic field are just two sides of the same coin. The formula is, if you consider the same basic cause, if you consider the dipole moment of both and try to find electric field and magnetic field, the formulas look exactly the same. Alright? Any doubts? You know, in fact, we will come back to this magnetic dipole moment little later also, where you know you will see that torque because of magnetic dipole moment is m cross b, which is same as p cross e. Okay, we will come back to this later on. All of you understood this? We'll come back to that later.